things will just happen.
Pero wag mo siguro tayo masyadong mag-sari. Wag na tayo masyadong. Pero kung nalang tayo, hindi magkano.
If Your Honor, please, I apologize to this seeming disrespect to this Honorable Court. There is no intention whatsoever. There is a misapprehension, Your Honor. In fact, he is taking his medicine and attending to personal necessity.
Session resumed. Ladies and gentlemen who have been patient, I warn you, if you are going to continue to be disorderly, I will ask the Sergeant at Arms to escort all of you out of this session hall. So I hope you understand the decorum required by this court. You may do it in some other place, but not in this court. So order.
After a very long opening statement by Chief Justice Renato Corona, I think it came as a surprise to everyone, when after he had offered his signed waiver for his dollar accounts and all his assets, even asking 189 members, the prosecution and Senator Franklin Drilon, to offer a waiver for theirs, the Chief Justice had just stood up and asked to be excused.
Nobody can get out of the Senate. I've ordered all the doors closed. And I do not want any defiance of the powers of this impeachment court. If you are going to do this disrespect in this court will make a decision of this case right now.
May I be permitted, Your Honor, to check up on his whereabouts?
All right, session is suspended for 1 minute.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Well, there's actually confusion and consternation all mixed together now at the Senate Impeachment Tribunal after Chief Justice Corona offering what could have been a bombastic condition that he had signed his waiver, opening his peso and dollar accounts to scrutiny, but laying the condition that all 188 complainants in the House of Representatives, including some of the senator judges and the prosecution, to also sign a waiver for them to open their peso or bank accounts to scrutiny. And then suddenly the Chief Justice upping and leaving from the witness stand without any buyer leave from the Senate presiding officer, causing a lot of consternation there. The Senate presiding officer ordering the lead defense counsel, former Justice Serafin Cuevas, to bring his client back to the session hall, or in this case, maybe cited for contempt.
A firm but strong presiding officer, Enrile, even warned Justice Cuevas to call on his client. You've heard Cuevas actually apologizing and even saying that perhaps the Chief Justice had to answer his personal necessities. But Enrile even stating that all the doors of the Senate had been closed, being firm that no one is to disrespect the court, and threatening that if this would be the action, a decision would be made now. Adele and Linda are at the Senate. From where you stand, what is happening? Do you have any word where the Chief Justice is right now in the Senate? Well, you know, there was a commotion in the hallways just after the Chief Justice left without a buyer leave from the court, left the court saying he wants to be excused, apparently, or giving the impression that he doesn't want to take any more questions either from the defense or the prosecution. And, you know, our cameras followed him through the hallway. The group went towards the elevators, but at this point, and I'm pretty sure because we're in a virtual state of lockdown here, they have locked the doors where, you know, the vehicles from the basement exit or enter, and that's where the convoy or the car of the Chief Justice is. So I'm pretty certain that he's still somewhere in the building. But of course, we've seen Attorney Dennis Manalo, one of the defense lawyers, there
he went
in
out
front of the Senate
to take a
he
cigarette
went through
break.
The pedestrian, the pedestrian exit and
right.
entrance.
Now, Adele, I wanted to ask you, what the Chief Justice did, does this mean in a way it's a signal that he is not going to take any questioning from either the defense or the prosecution? That he just wanted to say his piece? And it seems, is that what he's saying?
Well, let's see how this develops, because according to Justice Cuevas, there was an excuse why he went out. But, you know, of course, in an ordinary trial, the witness is only about to